honourable members. Respected Speaker, ma'am, honourable members, I'm extremely happy to make my maiden speech on the occasion on address of Honourable President of India. Firstly, I would like to object to the words of Kalyan Banerjee ji. Today he has commented on our Honourable Chief Minister Nara Chandrababu Naidu garu, and also for misleading the House that he was arrested by ED and CBI. But our Honourable Chief Minister Nara Chandrababu Naidu garu was arrested by AP CID in my very own parliament, that is Nandyal. Nandyal Parliament is a very, since decades, it has been Congress and YSRCP strongly ruled. But I would like to question Banerjee ji, why do you think Nandyal Parliament has won 7-on-7 assembly seats? And why do you think I have won more than the majority he was boasting about today? Why do you think people of Andhra Pradesh has given clear mandate by Telugu Desam Party with NDA Alliance and Janasena winning 164 out of 175 seats and 21 out of 25 parliament seats? He has also mentioned, he was very sarcastic. I wish he was here today at this session, but he was very sarcastic today. He mentioned our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji is walking with two clutches, and one clutch is Telugu Desam Party. Sir, remember, I thought you were the senior most leader with immense knowledge, but please remember that the clutch you are talking about is not a clutch, but it's a sword. And as you can see, the world has witnessed our leader Nara Chandrababu Naidu garu, who has transformed Hyderabad and Secunderabad into a IT or biocon hub, how he has improved the farmers' lives, how our per capita income was increased. So I would also like to remember that the youth of our state have been improved. They were employed under the rule of Telugu Desam Party. Our country coronates to be the third largest economy very soon. And I'm sure Telugu Desam Party is going to become the jewel in that crown under the leadership of Nara Chandrababu Naidu garu, Pavan Kalyan garu, and the future of Andhra Pradesh, Nara Lokesh garu. For the past 5 years, I would like to remind every citizen of Andhra Pradesh, when the country was developing, YSRCP, the past government, for the past 5 years, it has missed the development bus. The YSRCP, due to its unhealthy fiscal policies, now the state we have acquired is in severe economic crisis. As I can say, Amaravati, ma'am, is there any state without a capital in this country? That is our Andhra Pradesh. I need 1 minute, ma'am. This is the first time I'm speaking. This is the maiden speech. It's just 1 minute. The Amaravati, the foundation was laid by our Prime Minister and Nara Chandrababu Naidu garu. But then, after YSRCP came into power, they have opted for three capitals. And these three capitals, not even a foundation, not even a stone was laid. And Polavaram project, and 33,000 fertile acres of fertile land was donated by our Amaravati farmers, which has gone to waste. And Polavaram project, not even 70% was completed by Telugu Desam Party, but not even 1% was built. About 13,000 crores were given in July 15, 2022, to YSRCP party, but it was completely used for corruption. And 8,000 crores were given from the central government to the Panchayati Raj, which not even a rupee was used for our village panchayats. Not even a single industry, not even a single IT company, especially in my region, Rayalaseema region, not even a single IT company was brought by the YSRCP. All we saw was vendetta politics, liquor mafia, sand mafia, and also land mafia, but nothing else. As you can see, YSRCP party, Yuvajana Shramik, Raitu party, youth of our state have gone begging. Then Shramiks, we have seen their hunger, suicide, and our farmers, we have seen the suicides of the farmers. So I only Abdesh request, Prasad. My only request is, I would like the union minister, union government Abdesh to support Prasad. Our state, because...
बोलिए आप प्लीज।
माननीय सभापति जी, मैं आपके प्रति बहुत ही आभारी हूँ कि आपने दुनिया के विशालतम लोकतंत्र के मंदिर में मुझे अपना विचार रखने का मौका दिया है।
वेरी सीनियर मेंबर तोल तिरमाओ 11 हैज स्पोकन. I'll say this, if you allow me, both in English and Tamil. He is requesting the Union Government to invoke provisions given in the Constitution, particularly referring to the preamble, to bring in prohibition and also to ensure that there are no drug in the country, a very noble cause. I really appreciate the point he's raised there, but the party with which he is in alliance in Tamil Nadu, which is in government there, saw 56 people die due to illegal liquor. He should first preach there. He should first preach there. He should first talk there. Drug is rampant in Tamil Nadu. He should talk there rather than tell us, madam.
Thank you. Dr. B. Shabri. Dr. B. Shabri. Dr. Shabri.
Respected Speaker, ma'am. Respected Speaker, ma'am.